Are there any Vietnamese friends here? Please put up your hands up. Okay, there are some. Xin chào mọi người. Good afternoon to all of you. Present here in India, we say Namaste. I would like to start with a prayer. Sarve bhavantu sukhina, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchit dukh bhag bhave. Om shanti, shanti, shanti. This prayer means, my friends, if you want happiness for yourself, pray for the happiness of others. In life, we have all learned, if you want respect, learn to give respect. If you want love, you have to give back love. Similarly, if we all aspire for our own success, we have to ensure the success of others. We have to ensure that the chain above us and below us also succeeds, so that our success is ensured. Success cannot be an accident. Has to be a design. Friends, can you tell me what you know about sustainability? Anyone? Anything you can share? What do you think is sustainability? Yourself.
For me?
Survival of the fittest.
Pardon me?
Survival of the fittest.
Okay, that can be an option.
Well, there's many different aspects of sustainability. And I think that many people have different definitions of sustainability. But sustainability is sometimes confused with quality.
Okay.
And that's not necessarily true.
Sustainability relates to quality. Yes, sir.
Leaving the... Is working.
Hello?
Leaving the world or your community or yourself better than when you found it.
Yes, that is a very good explanation. Leave the world a better place than it is right now. Sustainability is all about longevity. A long race. Being able to plan ahead of the challenges of tomorrow. We all knew since last 2 years, China had stocks more than they could manage. Did we plan for our future? We are all waiting for China to do something, to deplete their stock. They have their own problems, they have their own issues. Why would they worry about us before themselves? They will not. They should not. So what have we done? What have we planned for ourselves if China does not deplete the stocks in the next 10 years? So rather than discussing the problems, let us get into the most probable solutions to the basics. What is possible at the root level for us? At the macro level, I'm sure that there's very little that we can do. But at the micro level, as an individual, we can definitely start somewhere. That is the topic of the day, my friends. For me, sustainability of the cotton supply value chain. Either all will survive or none will. We may be individuals in our life. That is what we think, but we have family, we have a social circle. Likewise in business. We have somebody above us who is buying from us, somebody below us who is selling to us. They both have to survive. Let me ask you a question. As you all know, India is famous for diamonds, if you have been to India. Is the value of an individual diamond more or a necklace of diamonds? There are a lot of Indians, they can answer. Is the value of an individual diamond more or a necklace of diamonds? Manish, can you try it?
Yeah.
Diamonds.
Depends on how much carat you are talking about.
You are again getting into the technicalities. The issue is a diamond and a necklace of diamonds.
Or a necklace worth 1 carat, that doesn't make sense.
That is where we go wrong. we think too much. A diamond is a diamond. A necklace of diamond means a necklace of that same carat of diamond. So, one diamond X cents, a set of necklace of diamonds of X multiplied by 12 cents. What would be more valuable?
The girl who is wearing the diamond is more valuable.
Yes. That is where we are so strong. For us, the diamond is most important, not the necklace. The whole textile supply value chain may be bleeding, but we are doing well in our segment, and we say we are smart. We are playing lucky. Tomorrow, we are going to be on that side. So we should not elevate ourselves from the big picture of the whole supply value chain. That is what I want to share with you. Yesterday, we had a brief discussion with a representative from Bangladesh. What would a spinner prefer, volatility or stability? We have seen volatility in the last 4 years. We have seen stability this year. What would you prefer? Volatility brings opportunities. A year like 2011 doesn't come often. It's a once in a decade occurrence. We should not set it as an example to avoid volatility. It is unavoidable. Better to accept it. The faster we accept it, the faster we find options. Volatility brings opportunities. There are risk management practices available which can help you capitalize on those opportunities. Are we planning about that? What is the risk management system that we have set for our business so that we can benefit from this current times? Markets have been damn steady. The range of 5 to 7 cents. Who would buy? Everybody knows the market's not going to go up. So where is the cushion of selling a yarn 3 months in advance? Why would your garment buy? He knows the market not going to go up. Where would the spinner buy cotton worth millions of dollars for the next 3 months? He doesn't see the market going up. We have to think differently. Stability does not always mean opportunity. For a period of time, yes, but for the whole season, it can be very dangerous. So, getting to our next slide. King cotton. A truly sustainable, eco-friendly and renewable natural resource. Some speakers before me have highlighted some of the points. And one of them has said that cotton has to be told as a story. I congratulate you all for being part of the textile industry, the oldest profession known to man. Since man has learned the concept of civilization, man has been very close, and that is when the textile mills on a very small scale have come into existence. 5,000 year old business, and you all are part of it. I am part of it. I am extremely proud to be part of it. Supply of synthetic and chemical fibers, not sustainable as it comes from petrochemicals, which have a lifespan, and which are not eco-friendly. Cotton has been grown since 5,000 years, will continue to grow, as you can see, and every year cotton plantation cycle renews itself. Renewable natural resource, and without doubt, it is the most comfortable and breathable fiber and fabric. COTTONGURU has some basic suggestions if we all can implement. I've been speaking at various seminars about this. Some people have welcomed, some have already initiated this. And I congratulate this very hotel. They have started something like that. Cotton handkerchief versus tissue paper. Can you just think about that? At least we Indians are so used to handkerchiefs. We are used to cotton handkerchiefs in centuries. And it is reusable. It is hygienic once washed. tissue paper, it comes from trees. Then, cotton bags versus plastic and paper bags. Plastic has been replaced by paper. But is paper bag a sustainable product? Paper comes from wood pulp, which comes from cutting the trees. Again, it's a one-time, two-time use. We cannot use paper bags more than 2 to 3 times, but cotton bags, our ancestors have been using that. They are for a very long time. And now we get the designer bags. So, we can see. I got one. And I'm proud to use it. The Environment Protection Agency data shows that every year we need to cut 9 million trees to make tissue paper. Every year we need to cut 4 billion trees to make paper. Are we moving towards sustainability? Are we moving towards protecting our own industry? I doubt that. Are we saving the earth or shaving the earth? You can see the area which is circled. 100 years back, look at the green vegetation in that part of Asia. And look at it now. It is very similar to a head which has thick growth of rich air and now which is balding. The more we promote cotton, the more we secure the future of cotton and the textile industry. Cotton textile is a fabric of life. Demand and utility of most products, as we know, my friends, is cyclic or periodic, but not cotton textile. It's a perennial business, never ending. Cotton textiles are preferred by the masses as well as the classes now, as you can see from the pictures. The three pillars of sustainability, we come to the topic sustainability. How do we sustain, how do we begin the process? We have to think about the planet, the people and profits. Planet, because we must ensure that we must make this planet a safe place to live. Protecting the environment and natural resources is a key thread of the sustainability concept. So any time that you start a business, first think about the planet. Then come the people. The customer is the king. As all management teachers teach us, do not fail on that. The customer is the key to determine the value of a supply chain. If there is a complaint, rather than arguing with the customer, let us go back to our own office and work out what is going wrong in our system. Profit. Without profit, why do we do business? There is no sense. Consistency and sustainability will pay back rapidly in terms of financial as well as environmental terms. Experiments on this have proved that. A 50,000 square meter green building can every year save about $30,000 in electricity cost and $15,000 in water cost. So why don't we try that? Benefits of a sustainable cotton supply value chain. Why should we go towards sustainability? Supply chain management is the backbone of any organization. China today is suffering because it did not pay adequate heed to the supply chain management. The logistics are not working out anymore. Yesterday, what seemed advantageous is a disadvantage today. Labor. It's become costly day by day, and the labor charges have increased 3 times in the last 5 years, tripled in the last 5 years. Power, we are one of the top 8 costliest countries in the world for a unit of power. For a company, a sustainability concept ensures profitable growth, creates value, win-win situation for all segments, above and below you. Cost minimization, which is the need of the hour, and transparency, which is the need of your customer. A sustainable supply chain results in overall economic, social, and environmental growth of a company. In future, my friends, supply chains will become more important than our product chains. part to sustainability. Where do we begin? Byproducts. Are we paying enough attention to our byproducts? They are not a waste. We have to make optimum use of byproducts. Like in cotton, in India, what we do is we promote the use of cotton seed. 65% of seed cotton is seed. There is